First thing, you will have additional two sessions in Saturday morning from 8:30 to 12:30. Right? Here, for the 2 days we miss, because we have these 2 days. To cover that, I will, and the Suraj will arrange Saturday morning to discuss two sessions. If you can participate, come, or otherwise, you can take the videos, right? I will cover the lessons required in Saturday morning. 8:30, 12:30 is okay, right? That's about that two missed lessons. Okay, now this is the other settlement discount on debtors. The question relating to the settlement discount. Have you discussed this question? No. On this point, we have to continue. Read the question. Company has annual credit sales of 12,000 million. Annual credit sale, that is 12 month sales, 12 million in 12,000. And 3 months are allowed for payments. 3 months are allowed for payments means 3 months debtors you have. 3 months sales will have as debtors. Got it? Right, therefore you should have 3 months sales as debtors, because 3 months they allow. That's the way you identify the debtors. The company decided to offer 2% discount for payment made within 10 days of the invoice being sent, and they reduced the maximum time allowed for payment for 2 months. If you allow 2% discount, your debtor will reduce, the debtor collection period will reduce to 2 months. Then 2 month sales will have as debtors with the new proposed method. It is estimated that 50% of customer will take the discount. 50% of the customer will take the discount. Required, if the company required 20% return on investment, calculate the effect of the discount. Assume that the volume of sales will be unaffected by the discount, right? That is, currently you have 12,000 sales per month and 3 months debtors period. Therefore, you will have 3,000 debtors per month. Is it clear? That is the current situation. With the 2% discount, you are going to reduce your debtors. But 2% discount will be consumed by only 50% of the customers. Now, this is the current debtor situation. Is it clear? Right. Always you need to calculate the current situation. In this case, right? Current debtors 3,000. If the policy is changed, the volume of account receivable would be, volume of account receivable would be, look at the policy. What is the policy they are given? The company decided to offer 2% discount for payment. 2% discount for payment. You can see at the end of the year, you can't get it. Right? When to take this 2%, debtors required to settle within 10 days, clear? They required to settle within 10 days. Due to this situation, they expected to reduce entire data collection period to 2 months. Their expectation, 50% of the customer will take the advantage. That means out of these 12,000 debtors, 6,000 debtors will consume this 2% discount. Is it clear? That 6,000 debtors collection period become 10 days. Clear? Balance 6,000 debtors collection period become 2 months. Therefore, current debtor balance, you can see 12,050%. Here also 12,050%. That is finally 6,000 for both cases. For this 6,000, 12 month, out of 12 months, 2 months period. For these debtors, out of 365 days, only 10 days. Because 50% of the debtors will consume their assumption. Based on that, your new debtors will be 1,164. Clear? Previous debtors was 3,000. Is it clear? There will be a reduction in account receivable this by this amount. This is the reduction in account receivable, right? Is it clear? How to calculate previous debtors and current debtors? Since the company can invest 20% a year, the value of reduction in account receivable in 20% of 100,835 each year in perpetuity, that is 367,123 a year. What is that? You need to understand what they are going to do. Now, this was the previous debtors 3,000. This is the new debtors under new policy. Therefore, your debtors reduced by 1,835. Right? The meaning of that, you will have cash amounting to 1,835 in each year. Is it clear? Because in the previous method, there was 3,000 debtors. From this year onward, you will have 1,164 debtors. Right? That means from this year onward, you will have additional cash of 1,835. Am I correct? From this year, you will have 1,835 additional cash on your hand. Is it clear? Now you should have, you have to invest this cash because no need to keep with the local. You have to invest this cash in somewhere. Right? We will assume company having a going concern. Clear? Since the company having going concern and their return, company requires return of 20%. Clear? Company requires return of 20%. Therefore, since the company can invest 20% a year, the value of the reduction is account receivable is 20% of this amount each year in perpetuity, you will receive it until the infinity. This is the present value. Got it? This is the present value you can collect it. Therefore, this is the present value, right? And this is the discount you allowing. 12,000, only half of debtors will take the opportunity. 2% is a discount. Therefore, this is the discount cost, 120. This is the present value of cash, additional cash you will collect from this year onward up to the infinity. Is it clear? I will put it in the right? Because from this year onward, you will have additional cash amount of 1,835. The present value up to the infinity under this rate, 367. Now you will calculate the net present value. It is 247. It's a gain for you. Clear? Right. Now you cannot apply this technique in always in the old questions. Then you require to understand in what circumstances I can apply this. Right? Settlement discount. If you receive the question only on discount settlement on debtors, right? And when you have additional cash benefit from the year you are going to apply a new policy, right? You require to calculate the net present value of the cash flows. What is the net present value? Present value of additional cash minus the discount cost you allowed. Okay. Therefore, write down that point. Write down evaluation of settlement discount. Evaluation of settlement discounts. Under that, you can write down. Evaluation will be depend on the net present value of the cash flows. right? Entity requires to calculate the present value of additional cash. Additional cash. Additional cash means within bracket you can take as no, that the reduction of debtor balance. Reduction of debtor balance. Oh, entity requires to calculate the present value of the additional cash and compare it with the discount cost. Right, let's take next example, receivable management. Company achieves current annual sales of 1,800. Current annuals, always think how they are present in the figures, annual sales, right? Then you can easily calculate the debtors based on the collection period. The cost of sale is 80%. Cost of sale is 80%, then you can take the gross profit, right? Summarize. While you read the summarize the information. Sales 1,800, cost of sale 80% means gross revenue is 20%. That is 360. Gross revenue is 360. Right? While you read the question, you have to summarize the information. But bad debt average is 1% of total sales. Now currently you have bad debt average of 18 million, right? 1% of total sales means 18 million. 1,800 is the total sales. 1%, 18 million is the bad debt. Now gross revenue, 360. Bad debt, 80. Your sales will produce 360 million gross revenue to you. But in other side, your sales will produce 18 million cost to you as bad debt. Therefore, your net gain is 342. Right? While you read the question, you have to summarize this. Is it clear? That's why study text provided information like this. Just information is given. Clear? The current debt collection period is 1 month. And the management consider that if credit terms were eased, that is option A, the effect would be as follows. Current debt collection period is 1 month means 1 month debtor sales are the debtors. Divide by 12 multiplied by 1 is the debtors. You can calculate that is 150. Clear? You are summary karagan. Now company going to introduce new policy called option A. These are the information available for option A when comparing with the present policy. Additional sales with the present policy, you don't have additional sales. But option A, 25% additional sales. Then all that make a liya yando. And you can't do anything. You can't do anything. You can't do anything. With an additional sale kiwa gaman payanak karan liya gan, how much the total sales? 1800 currently. 25% on that is 450. Then 2250 is the new sale. Clear? 2250 is the new sales, right? Average collection period currently 1 month, therefore data is 150, remember? Remember summary karane? Current 1 month credit period, therefore data was 150. That's atasiyani total sales, therefore 1 month is 150. New data collection period is 2 month. 2 month not on 1800, 2 month on 2250. Then divide by 12, multiplied by 2 is a new data. විභාගයට අහන්නේ වෙන එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් මේ ඔක්කොම කියලා අහයි කොළඹට රත්නපුර ඉඳන් කොච්චර දුරද කියලා ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ based on the available information you have to analyze this sometimes when you are analyzing you don't need to calculate again it because you will reach the answer when you analyze in while you reading but the student doing at the exam they are reading just as a novel issued by Sujiya Prasanna Raj right you are just reading මාර කික් එකක් ඇත්ත ඔහි ප්‍රශ්නයක් කියවයි යදී හිතන්නේ නැතුනේ 아무තුම කික් එකක් ඒකෙත් තියෙනෝනේ ඇත්තට කිසිම දෙයක් හිතන්නේ නැතුව බරපතලක් නැතුව ලබන පාර විභාගය දානවා කියලා මානසිකත්වයක් හදාගෙන මේ පාර එක්සෑම් ෂීට් එකේ වාඩි වෙලා ප්‍රශ්න පත්‍රය කියනකොට 아무තුම කික් එකක් තියෙනෝනේ හිත නිදාස්නේ ඒක තමයි තියෙන්නේ ප්‍රශ්නේ ඒත් එළියට ඇවිල්ලා යාළුවෙකුටත් මැසේජ් එකක් දාන වැඩක් නෑ මචං මේ පාර කියලා ඊළඟ පාරත් ඒකම දාන්න කොපි කරලා පේස්ට් කරන්න විතරයි තියෙන්නේ Right. Then bad debt percentage currently 1%. You can 18. Propose 3%. 2250. 3% 67.5. 67.5. Right, the company requires 20% return on investment. That is their requirement. Sometimes you have to use this as the discounting factor to discount future cash flows. Right, sometimes you need to use this rate as to calculate return on assets. The cost of sale 75%, variable cost 25%. The cost of sales are 75%. Variable and 25% fixed. Here, 80% is cost of sale given. Right? Now, make a cost of sale like a pulwand. How much the cost of sale currently? Summary karan ko here. Current cost of sale how much? 80%. 1440. Right. 1440 is the current cost of sale. 75% variable. How much the fixed? 25% fixed. 1440. 25% on that key and how much? 144, 288, 200, sorry? 316. 360 is the fixed cost. Now, fixed cost is fixed whatever decision. Got it? Therefore, you should have the fixed cost, same fixed cost in the new decision also. ඒක තමයි මම කැල් කරන්නේ. දැන් ගාන හැදිලා ඉවරයි බලන්න. 360 fixed cost is fixed in whatever addition. Right? Within the capacity. Assume that there would be no increases in fixed cost. නෝ කියන්නේ. ඒ කියන්න දෙයක් නැහැ. අපේ ළමයිට කියන්න ඕනේ තිය එකයි. Right? Assume there would be no increases in fixed cost from the extra revenue. And that there would be no increases in average inventory so account payable because if you have any average increase in data so payable you have additional investments there but here you don't have additional investment in debtors and sorry stocks and creditors identify which is the preferable policy option A or the present one now all the information you have with you Now you can calculate net profit in both cases. You have to calculate two profit and loss. The increase in profit before the cost of additional finance for option A can be found as follows. Increase in contribution from additional sale. Additional sales is 25% on current sale. Clear? Is it clear? 1800 into 25% additional sales. You already calculated additional sales as 450. They have given cost of sale. Cost of sale will include both variable and fixed cost. But to take decisions in management accounting, we are using marginal costing techniques, that is variable cost and fixed cost. To take those marginal costing techniques, you require to calculate contribution ratio. Right? Now you have available information for current sale, 1800, and current variable cost. You told me the fixed cost as 360, am I correct? Out of 1440 is the total cost of sale of the current situation, am I correct? You have summarized. Within that, you will have 360 fixed cost, am I correct? Then how much the variable cost there? How much the variable cost there? I am talking about the current situation. 1800 is the sales. 80% is cost of sale, that is 1440. 25% fixed cost. 75% variable cost. Correct? This is 360. This amount. 1080 or 1180? 1080. Right. This is variable cost. Then contribution sales ratio. Sales, this amount. Contribution, this amount. As a percentage, how much? 40%. Sorry? How about the contribution? The difference between this contribution? This is sale. This is variable cost. Yeah. 40%? Ayyo ayi manyang wage inne. Puthe saamaanya shishyatta panthiyak wage ne meka. Da mehema kiyannam koma. Vi sadya adu hinda da therenne nathe. Katha karoth karanna wenna ada ekai hariyen. Vikunum 1800 nam bang. විචල්ල පිරුවේ 1080 නම් වෙනස දායකය නෙමෙයිද? ඕක විකුණුම් බෙදුම් වලින් බෙදුවම දායක විකුණුම් අනුපාතය එන්නේ නැද්ද? ඈ. අය නිකන් බය වෙලා වගේ ඉන්නේ. මේක 2008 ඉඳන් A level syllabus එකේ තියෙනව නේද? නැද්ද? නෑ කියන්නේ දැන්. මේක 2008 ඉඳන් A level syllabus වලත් තියෙනවා. A level ගුරුරුත් උගන්වනවා. A level ළමයිට ලියනවා විභාගත් පාස් වෙනවා ලංකාවේ පළවෙනියත් වෙනවා කැම්පස් උත් යනවා චාඩට් කරන්න පටන් ගත්තම බැරි වෙනවා නේ ඇයි ඒ වර කේස් එක ඒක නිසා මේ සිම්පල් නේ this is we have identified variable cost here therefore this is the contribution 1800 න් 1080 කඩු කරාමනේ contribution and divide by sales I think it is 40% Right, now look at that answer A. You will have additional sales of 25% on current sale, clear? Over that sale, you have 40% of contribution. Therefore, contribution on additional sale, how much? 180. Less increase in bad debt. How much the bad debt? You already calculated. Over this? 67.5. But you had 18, right? Therefore, increase bad debt, how much? 49.5. This is the additional gain. This is the additional cost. And this is the net benefit over option A. Clear? Now, look. In the question, they have given cost of sale information, gross profit information, net profit information. However, evaluating the decision, you will depend on marginal costing techniques or any other technique. Marginal costing technique. Always you have to take additional benefit based on the contribution, not the gross profit. Clear? To take the decision, we will take additional contribution always, point it out. Very important. They have provide profit and loss account. Right? It may include cost of sale, distribution, administration, expenses, but you will identify how much the variable cost and how much the fixed cost there. Then you will identify the contribution. You always calculate the additional contribution, not additional gross profit from the decision. Over the given information, you need to calculate contribution ratio. Got it? Now, they have calculated contribution ratio. This is a contribution ratio, 40%. Therefore, this is a contribution of additional sale. This is the additional bad debt. You already calculated both current bad debt and previous bad debt. Therefore, this is the additional gain. Right. Okay, then look the answer B. Proposed investment in account receivable. 2 months scale and give it. 2 months. Make an amount again. Less current investment account receivable. Additional investment required, 225. Debtors will increase by this amount. Cost of financing, 20%. Therefore, this is the additional cost on additional debtors. And question told you there is no any increase in inventories and payable. No any increase on debtors and payable, sorry, stocks and payable. You have to add any increase in debtors or, sorry, inventories or payable if the examiner provides those information. Now they silent about that is nil. Therefore, 225 into 20% cost. As the increase in profit exceeds the cost of additional financial, option A should be adopted. What is that conclusion? That is the question. Read that part C of the answer. And try to understand what they explain. Through the option A, you have additional income of 133. Your cost of capital will be 45. Therefore, you have gain. Nearly 85 or 90. Gain you have 95. 85, right? 85 gain you have. Therefore, you can recommend them to go with the option A. Clear? Right. Now we are moving to the factoring, right? Next issue. benefit of factoring, just read those things and take into your mind. Okay. I'm not going to explain. I will give you a few minutes to understand and solve this question. This is factoring example. We'll have all the information. I think that's the strategy to answer the question. Company makes annual credit sales of 1,500. Credit term of 30 days, but its debt administration has been poor and average collection period has been 45 days. Therefore, 1,500 will be divided by 365 and multiplied by 45, or 1,500 will be divided by 12 and multiplied by 1.5. We'll have the current debtors. Am I correct? 1,500 will be divided by 12, multiplied by 1.5 since it is 45 days. 1.5, then you have data, right? Nithane wali yaage nathe, current debtors. Then 0.5% result in bad debt means, eddas pansita dasam pahakne, ikane 7.5 is the current bad debt. Clear? Current option neke detail venama liyaage. Sales 1,500, debtors kiye denne. Eva liya gatte nadd? Amata current debtors. It does fancy the lime bed like as some paying medical. You can enter in out three. Dolahem beduama hurried. It can see a visi pie. Eh? One make the aval hit again. It can see visi pie, kind of some paying medical. It can see a visi pie hakui. It came baggy queenie. Again, hatatism pie. 187.5, right. Now let's see the factors proposal. A factor would take the task of debt administration and debt credit checking at an annual fee of 2.5 on of credit sales. So got a factor fee again or 2.5 on this. Again, TI, T7.5. 37.5 is the factor fee. It was like a new proposal. When I'm a Liagan, Arakasim Gilati, then him a Lian table. In the new proposal, 1,500 into 2.5, that is factor fee. Right? 37.5. The company would save 30 million. Then saving of debt administration cost. Meva mataka da api liya gatta palawenima dawase. When you factor in these are the benefit kiyala. You can save the administration cost kiyala. E me liya gatte me watenna hari. When you are factoring, you are not going to employ collection staff, right? Administration cost will reduce by 30 million. It's a gain, right? The payment period would be 30 days. Again, 125 is the debtor. Got it? 1 month, 125 is the, 25 is the debtor. The factor would also provide an advance 80% of invoice debt. Again, debtors like in Sierra Suga Nayat Denwalu. How much the debtor loan? Sierra Suga can it does this year. Right? 1200 is the loan. Their interest rate is 14%. Right? Then you can calculate the interest there. Based over 3% over base rate, therefore base rate in the market is 11%, right? But they can obtain borrowing from OD 2.5 over base rate, that is 13.5. Clear? That is the OD rate is 13.5. The OD rate 13.5. Factors loan rate 14%, right? Advise whether factor service should be accepted or not. This is the answer. The current situation is as follows. 1,500 sales, average credit period 45 days. This is the calculation of debtors. Clear? This is calculation of debtors into 13.5. And this is what? Borrowing cost on OD. Clear? They have calculated borrowing cost on OD. They have calculated first how much the debtors. Because you no need to borrow entire amount of the cash, sorry, sales. Because you will have debtor balance. You cannot collect that debtor balance. Amount equal to debtor, you need to borrow cash. Got it? Right. Now, current debtor is this. You already calculated the current debtors. 187 amount. Then OD rate is this. Therefore, this is the OD interest. Bad debt is this. Administration cost is this because still you are in the current situation. Got it? Therefore, in the current situation, you have three costs there. Administration cost 30. I think we have calculated 7.5 bad debt. And now there is no factor. Then you will rely only on OD. You don't have cash equal to the debtors. Therefore, you will borrow amount equal to debtor at 13.5. Therefore, your total cost on the current situation is 62.466. Okay. The current cost. Right? Now, let's see the additional cost of new decision. The cost of the factor, 80% of credit sales financed by the factor would be 80% of rupees 1,500. How much they are going to provide as the loan? 1,200. For a consistent comparison, we must assume that 20% of credit sales would be financed by bank overdraft. Otherwise, you have issue. Now, factor will provide finance facility on only 80%. Again, you have a balance to be financed. Then we will assume, that's the assumption in the question, that balance 20% will be financed through the existing option of OD. Is it clear? Right. Therefore, this is the interest cost. Look how they calculated. 1,200 debtors and 300 debtors you bifurcated as 20% and how much? 80%. Then this 80% debtor collection period with the factoring is 1 month. Has reduced to 1 month. Therefore, this is the debtor, this is the rate, remember. But balance 20%, debtor collection period is same, therefore debtors is same. But you will finance through OD, therefore your total interest cost will be 17.137. Plus, you have bad debt, remember, 2.5. This is the bad debt we calculated. Therefore, this is the cost, 54. Yeah. Once you factored, you entered into that agreement. When you entered into that agreement, you had to follow that because you are not going to think about that. You will have 30 million saving in the cost administration of debt. Then you are not going to consider that 5% increase. Sometimes you have to consider. However, you entered into that agreement, you have to follow their rules. Now this is the cost, right? Now previous cost 62, new cost 54. Clear? Conclusion, the factor is cheaper. Why? The total cost will be 54 in factoring, here 62. Now you will wonder why they didn't consider here 30 million gain. No need to consider. In other option, they have considered it as an expense, 30 million. Therefore, no need to take as a gain here. Clear? So, when you have a cost, you have to get the net, you have to get the net. Same thing. And you have alternative answer. The incremental cost directly, you can calculate the benefit here. This is the make up. Look at the alternative answer. Effect of reduction in collection period. 45 to 30 days. Then 15 days debtors are the reduction of debtors, clear? Reduction of debtors, then extra interest cost, then cost of factor services, saving in bad debt, saving in company administration cost, and net benefit. That is the difference between the cost calculated in two options, remember? Right. That is factoring. I told you we have different strategies on debtors. Extending credit period, factoring, remember? I think you have taken this list. Right, then we will move into the creditors. Now, the purpose of managing creditors is this. Creditors means suppliers. You need to maintain your goodwill over them. Otherwise, they have the power than you. Then they will select another option, ignoring you. Therefore, satisfactory credit from suppliers, extended credit from suppliers, good relationship with them. Right? Now, this is cost of early payment discount. Let's see. Trade credit. Now keep your mind in working capital management. You don't have clear cut technique or format to solve a question. You will read the question and understand benefit and disadvantages, then you will compare and give the recommendation. Now this is credit. That is supplier related question. How they are going to manage their creditors. Okay, just read the question first. While you reading, what you need to do, compare always the current situation and proposed situation if there is a proposed method. Company has been offered credit terms from its major suppliers of 2/10 net 45. That is, a cash discount of 2% will be given if payment is made within 10 days of the invoice. And payment must be made within 45 days of the invoice. Now, summarize, creditor settlement period 1.5 month. Clear? If you settle within 10 days, you have 2% discount. Now you have to use the, you have to evaluate whether we are going to settle within 10 days and taken 2% discount, or whether we remain until 45 days, end of 45 days. Simple, ne? If you settle within 10 days, listen to me, mama, sarlani yang hitan no ne wakian. Now creditor will tell you, you can settle within 45 days. But if you settle within 10 days, I will give you 2% discount. Say you owe 100 rupees for me. Now you have that option. You can settle this 100 rupees to me within 10 days, then you have to pay only 98. Or you can wait until the 45th day and you can settle 100. If you wait until the 45th day, you have to pay additional 2 rupees. But from the 10th day to 45th day, you have 35 additional days to invest that 100 rupees in somewhere. Got it what I'm telling? That's the strategy. Clear? The meva kohiwa teka mangi meka rule wala standard wala ne. Awada da sa. Dawas 10 ekata me manusyata 98ak diila dekaak laaba gannawada. Naththan labena thiyena rupiyal deka athaharala 10 wen dawas indan 35 wen dawas enakan e salary tika kohari dala thiyela interest ekak. If your interest income more than 2 rupees, got it? What option you will select? Early settlement or waiting until 45 days? Waiting until up to the 45th day. The simple, I don't know what is the question here, but it's a strategy, right? Okay, let's see. The company has the choice of paying 98% or 98 cents per 1 rupee on 10 days. Monkey ne ke matama kiya ne ne? Or to pay before 10 days would be unnecessary, or invest that 98 for an additional 35 days and eventually pay the supplier 1 rupee after 1 day. Dahaveni dawasata awama rupiyal 98 ne gewanna naththana 100 wenne. Ada rupiyal 98 ay tawa dawas 5 25 35 ak ne. Dahaveni dawase ne api inne. Adi dan dawas 35 ak issarata mama rupiyalak denna ona. Mama ada rupiah rupiah lain rupiah siya. Mama ada rupiah lain orang tak koyak hari demam. Tahu dah pas tispa kini ek rupiah siya tu ada badi biru mana? Mana laba ini? Because I have to pay 100 rupees. Clear? I have to pay 100 rupees if I wait until the 45th days. I am on 10th day. I have 98 rupees on my hand. If I invest somewhere without paying to the supplier. If my cash will increase more than 100 rupees on the 45th day, I will invest there because I have an additional income. Clear? That's the way it comparing in the single way. Right. Recommend what the company should do. Refuse the discount. At the 45th day, you will pay. How much the liability you have? Higher? 1 million, right? Annual, obtain an annual return of 25% that there is an invoice from the supplier, 1 million, right? If you refuse the discount, you will until 45th day and will settle the entire amount, correct? Right? Return from investing. Now this is return rate. If you invest without paying at the 10th day, if you pay at 10th date, you no need to pay 1,000. You require to pay only 980. 2% discount there. At the 10th day, without repay this amount, you will invest. For 35 days, clear? You will invest for 35 days, not for the entire year. Once you invest 980 for 35 days at 25% rate, this is the additional income you have. Got it? Therefore, how much you have to finally pay? 976. If you accept the discount, you have to pay this today. Clear? No gain here because no investment there. It is cheaper to reduce the discount. Clear? Then make a kavidiyan. Tavidi and Mamaki and Puluan. Namasia sua dahavani that was a given netuwa. Namasia su investkan. That's this part. It will appear now, visit tonight the summer? Pa. Right? So total ke 1103 da sama pai ehemane return 1103 da sama pai ne dawas 45 weni dawase di 1000ak gewala 3ak ithira karaganna 3 da sama pak apita ithiri you will at the 10th day you have to pay 980 without repay that 980 if you invest you have a income of 23.5 therefore at the 45th day you will have 1003.5. At the 45th day, you have to pay only 1000. Now you have a saving of 3.5, you know, of reducing the discount. Clear? No need to depend on this on same way. Clear? Metra 3.5 ne wenasa peenawane. Clear? Right. Then inventory, final part of working capital management. First of all, tell me, do you need to understand the stock levels, EOQ, everything? Do you need to understand or do you need to explain it? The developing stock levels, everything you need. Right. And EOQ model also? No. Right, okay. First, develop the EOQ model. Write down, I will explain. You have to do it. Take extra page to take these additional notes. Right. First of all, write down. I am not going to write anything on the board. You need to develop by your mind. I will explain. Always you need to consider the cost. Managing inventories have a cost. Therefore, write down. Total cost of inventory equal. This is a formula, right? Total cost of inventory equal. Total cost of inventory equal total cost of inventory equal for what? A formula ka. Ordering cost issela order karanne pehne ordering cost plus purchase karanne pehne order karapu purchase cost plus purchase karuwa mokada karanna ona tiya ganna ona holding cost plus tiya gane idi mokada wenne stock out cost ekak enawane shortage cost idi menna mehema kiyanna puluwa hari man liyanna kiyala liye wenawa TC is equal ordering cost plus purchase cost plus holding cost plus shortage cost. Right? This is the stock cost. Let's see what are the each cost. Ordering cost, you know that communication expenses and traveling expenses sometimes to order you have to visit the suppliers and everything. That is ordering cost. Purchase cost means pay amount you pay to the supplier. Any taxes, right? non-reimbursable taxes, any carriage inwards, handling cost, everything in the purchase cost. Clear? Then holding cost means storage facilities and other related expenses. Shortage cost means stock out cost. Right. Now, basic EOQ model, we assume purchase cost cannot be controlled by the entity. Clear? Why? Purchase price will be decided by buyer or seller. In economy, you will tell both depend on the demand and supply, but who is the decider? Who is the person set the price? Seller. Then as the buyer, can you control it? Can't. Therefore, write down under purchase price, it cannot be controlled. But ordering cost you can control. How? Ordering cost means communication and traveling expenses. Then you can buy a chain and buy a chain. You can buy a chain and buy a sample. You can buy a visit taking. You can buy a visit taking. The plane negative ticket de paratum paragivana pula on a paragila masa kitanilla balagan in that pulua. Clear? Then email a kakavana pulu nata, a ordering already email levana pulua. Therefore, you can control the ordering cost. Clear? It can be controlled, no doubt. Holding cost also you can control by reducing or increasing the amount you purchase at once. Right? It will create the holding cost. When you are purchasing huge amounts of stocks, you need a huge area to store there. When you are purchasing small amounts, you require only small spaces to store it. But when you purchase small amounts, you have to order more times. Clear? Because practically, it's not a problem. When you purchase small amounts at once, you need to purchase more times. You need to order more times. Therefore, when you're purchasing small amounts, you have to do more orders and more ordering cost will increase. But holding cost will decrease because you have a small amount of purchase. Clear? To reduce the ordering cost, what you have to do? You have to reduce the number of orders. That means you have to purchase all requirement in one order or two or three orders. Then you will reduce the ordering cost, but the amount you purchasing will increase at once, therefore holding cost will increase. Therefore, you can see that holding cost and ordering cost will be running negatively, right? Not positively. Is it clear?
Right.
But both cost can be controllable by the entity. Shortage cost, stock out cost, diluting your goodwill, losing your customers, customer will shift into your competitors. Can you measure? Can you quantify? You can't. Therefore, purchase cost cannot be controlled. Shortage cost cannot be quantified. Therefore, for the decision making, we will consider only ordering cost and holding cost in the basic EOQ model. Ekanisai, depend on OC and HC, you will decide the EOQ. Net oye dekhe pattern dal samana karam ki utani karagatta me nahi karne me. Clear? You have to understand why we are. Mata podi gale level karaddi bhari prashnayan. Aap gaman uganna gen giya toge piriway kiyanne holding cost ekai ordering cost ekai kiyala. Net toge piriway kiyanne holding cost ekai ordering cost ekai kiyuwa gaman lamay ki manasata yanawani salli gewanawani supply ekata kiyanne gen oluwata yanne ne. In one of the other, well, then among a little pass it, the consult a gaddi titangi, purchase cost ticket, and ordering cost ticket. Mugabitoma Hatra clearly again, you know. Abrigua to give it again, Ozisa, let's see. The ordering cost never again a period. මගේ ඔලුවටම ආවි CIF cost insurance freight කොයිද තියෙන්නේ ඒක අපිට ඉස්සෙල්ලා කියන්නනේ මේ it cannot be controlled නේ therefore we will ignore it ඒකයි මෙතන නැත්තේ පුතේ කිව්වනම් අර එහෙම කිව්වේ නෑ එතකොට කිව්වේ නැතුනම් වෙන්නේ you will assume that that cost also included in ordering ordering cost එක කියන්නේ purchase prices මේ taxes transport handling cost නෙමෙයි ඔය tour එකක් ගිහිල්ලා බලලා එන ටික sample බලලා එන්නේ හරි ඊට පස්සේ ඔය import export import වලදී වගේ පුතේ ඔය එක එක අධික එක එක authority වලින් ගන්න දෙපැනේ license වල දන්නවද ඔය දැන ගැනීමට කියන්නේ ordering cost එකට example එකක් කියන්න අපි හිතමු අපි diamond order කරනවා කියලා diamond order කරද්දී පළවෙනිම දේ තමයි ලංකාවේ දැන් අපි ඕඩර් කරන්නේ පිටරටින් ඩයමන්ඩ් අපේ ලංකාවේ නැහැ නේ ඩයමන්ඩ් සෙල්ලම ලංකාවේ ජෙම් ඇන් ජුවලරි ඔතොරිටි එකෙන් අපි සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකක් ගන්න ඕනේ කොච්චරක් ඕඩර් කරනවද ඒකේ වැලියු එක කීයද කියලා ජෙම් ඇන් ජුවලරි එකෙන් අපිට සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකක් දෙනවා ලංකාවේ ඔය යුනයිටඩ් නේෂන්ස් රූල්ස් වලට අනුව හැම රටකම ජෙම් ඇන් ජුවලරි කියලා ඔතොරිටි එකක් තියෙන ඕනේ ඒක අපේ රටේ විතරක් තියෙන එකක් නෙමෙයි හැම රටකම අනිවාර්යෙන් තියෙන්න ඕන හරි මම ඉම්පෝර්ට් කරන කෙනා ජෙම් ඇන් ජුවලරි ඔතොරිටි එකෙන් ඕඩර් එකක් ගන්නවා I am going to import this amount of diamonds and this is the value this is a CIF value කියලා සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකක් ගන්න. එක්ස්පෝර්ටත් ඉන්නවනේ. එක්ස්පෝර්ටත් සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකක් ගන්න ඕනේ එයාගේ රටේ ජෙම් ඇන් ජුවලරි එක ඔතොරිටි මොකක් හරි නමක් ඇති. හරි? ජෙමා කියලා හරි ඇති කියන්නකෝ. ඒකිනුත් එයා සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකක් ගන්නවා I am going to export this amount of diamond කියලා. Then both export and import has to submit these two certificate. There is a single office to handle all the diamond transaction in the world, right? Halati de? Nee nee. Ikat ini dakunu Afrika bi Kimberley kena nagari. More close to that cricket ground. Kimberley is more famous for the cricket ground, right? In South Africa. Ye Kimberley kena nagari di mana set? ऑर्गनाइजेशन ने कोई लोगे में इकतुए ला आदेबु ये अलग सर्टिफिकेट तैयार दूंने तो बस अर सर्टिफिकेट देखा दूंना मैं एक्सपोर्ट आई इंपोर्ट आई दे विल इश्यू अ सर्टिफिकेट टू डू द ट्रांसैक्शन अदरवाइज मैं वराइंग भाड़ूटी का गांड में किम्बरी सर्टिफिकेट टेका दिए नो नहीं नवर दान ना मैं गान ना ऐ और दान ना हेतु एक एतो कोटो किम्बरी सर्टिफिकेट गांड जेम मैं ज्वेलरी के गिहला पे सर्टिफिकेट गांड आप गीगा मान देने वाले राज्य आयतन और टग गाला सर्टिफिकेट කාටවත් සල්ලි දෙන්නේ නැහැ ඉන්දියාවේම ඉන්දියාවෙන් පුතේ අපිට ගන්න බෑනේ සර්ටිෆිකේට් එක ජෙමිනා ජුවලරි එකෙන් ඉක්මනට ගන්න පුළුවන්ද පීඑන් ගිනම් පගාව දීගෙන යන්න ඕනේ පීඑන් ට දීලා ඇතුළේ ඉන්න අයට දීලා ලොක්කන්ට දීලා ඉන්දියාවේ එහෙමයි හරි ඉන්දියාව වගේ රටක අපි ඉපදුනා නම් ඕඩරින් කෝස්ට් එකට ඒ පගාව දෙන එකත් එනවා දැන් ලංකාවේ එහෙම නැහැ ගිය ගමන් අනිත් පැත්තට දෙනවනේ ඒක නිසා ඕඩරින් කෝස්ට් එකට සර්ටිෆිකේට් එකට ගෙවන ලීගල් ෆී ඒවා ස්ටැම්ප් ඩියුටිස් එනවා तो साउथ अफ्रीका किंबली की दें प्रोड्यूस करना किंबली सर्टिफिकेट देना कॉस्ट का मोटरिंग कॉस्ट अम कंट्रोल यूनिट का डायमंड लोके उन्होंने निका मीन नीति दारे लोके हरियट दिब प्रश्न साउथ अफ्रीका वाले स्लेव स्लायो दागा डायमंड हरगनी अंड पैन डायमंड वाला बलान फिल्म आती है ब्लड डायमंड स्लेव्स दाल वाद दीदी मे डायमंड खानी अपोलो ऐट तस निसन मैंडला महात्म्या उन्नवेला विरुद्ध वेड़ गिरफ्ने स्लेव्स दाल डायमंड नतर के तो डायमंड प्रोड्यूसर के सर्टिफाई करना लोकेट आई डिडंट यूज स्लेव्स स्लेव्स दाला खंड बन नदी अलग वेडगाट ये डायमंड ब्लड डायमंड मिनी मरो मरो डायमंड ब्लड डायमंड किंबली सर्टिफिकेट दिस इज नॉट अ ब्लड डायमंड एक्सपोर्ट प्रूव कर आई डिडंट यूज एनी स्लेव्स इन माय वर्क्स आई अडॉप्टेड प्रॉपर एम्प्लॉय एम्प्लॉयी रूल्स නොට බ්ලඩ් ඩයිමන්ඩ් කියන එක ප්‍රූව් කරන්නේ නැහැ. බ්ලඩ් ඩයිමන්ඩ් ලෝකේ ට්‍රාන්සැක්ට් කරන්න දෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඉට් ඉස් ජස්ට් ලයික් බ්ලැක් මනි. රයිට්? තොර බලන්නකෝ ඩයිමන්ඩ් ඕඩර් කරන ප්‍රොසෙස් එකේ මොන තරම් කෝස්ට් එකක් තියෙද ඩයිමන්ඩ් වලට ගෙවන එකට අමතරව කියලා. clear annika tha ordering cost right okay now how ordering cost created number of orders into cost per order liya ganneva sutra neme ordering cost equal number of orders into cost per order right how you can calculate the number of orders annual requirement divided by amount you purchase at once time right d divided by q cost per order co cost per order therefore d divided by q into co neither then holding cost when you talk about holding cost it is interesting right say this is the stores at the day zero this is the amount you have when time gradually passed your stock will gradually reduce but you are not wait until this point in this point you will increase then again gradually decrease therefore you are stock running like this right when you take a particular day on this date you have maximum stock but this date you have minimum amount of stock this day you have again maximum stock therefore when you take a single day one day out of 365 it is not the minimum and it is not the maximum it is the average because when you take the average line look here this area you don't have stocks but this area you have stock therefore meka galala metanta da mekat galala metanta da mekat galala metanta da then finally what happen per day you have average amount not the amount you purchase in a single day holding cost is cost holding cost per unit ch into average amount in the stores average amount in the stores means q divided by 2 clear මොකද ගබඩාව full වෙන්නේ එකපාර ගේන තොගේ එන්නේ ඒතර ඔක්කොම ටික එක දවසකට නැහැ නේ නැති වෙලත් නැහැ you will have average therefore q divided by 2 into ch and I have told you these two stocks will run in negatively therefore to keep in the optimal level it need to be equal if it is increase otherwise other side it will decrease but other expense will increase therefore to keep in minimum it should be a balance right therefore you will equal these two hari equal karala q tani karaganna balanna mokada wenney kiyala then we require to talk about reorder level. Right? Write down, I'm going to explain the reorder level formula. Okay. Simple thing. ඉතල මෙහෙම කියන්නම්. මේ හැමදේම තේරුම් ගන්න ඕන පුතේ. දැන් අපි විවිධ භාෂාවන් කතා කරන මිනිස්සුනේ. දැන් මම සිංහල කතා කරනවා. තව කෙනෙක් තමිල් කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. තව කෙනෙක් ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. තව කෙනෙක් ওই මික්ස් භාෂාවක් කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. හරි? මොකද මේ භාෂාව වැදගත් ඉගෙන ගනිද්දී හේතුව අපේ හදවතට දැනෙන්නේ අපේ මදර් ලැන්ග්වේජ් එකේ. That's the truth. Right? The medium is English, but you will have your own mother language. Take the medium to answer, but understand, think based on your mother language. That's very important. And don't think you have theories in the world. Clear? Gurutvakarshana balaya kiyanne gravity ne the gravity. Gravity කියන්නේ theory එකක් නේ. It's a theory. Newton නේද හැදුවේ. එතකොට gravity කියන theory එක when Newton developed at that time when he was developed it, right? Now from that date we are using this theory නේ. එතකොට අපි gravity කියන එක කටපාඩම් කරනවා as a definition. Then Newton mahatya oya definition එක හදනකන් apple ගහේම තිබ්බ වැටුනේම නැද්ද Newton mahatya definition එක හදන දවස වෙනකන් apple මිනිස්සු ගිහිලා කඩන් ආව මිස බිමට වැටුනේ නැහැ මිනිස්සු උඩ පැනනම බිම වැටුන්නේ නැහැ උඩ පැනනම් පාවි වී හිටියා නේ Newton mahatya theory හැදුවට පස්සේ නම් ඔක්කොම දේවල් බිමට වැටෙන්න ගත්තේ එහෙමද හැබැයි අපි හිතන්නේ එහෙමනේ පුතේ හරි ඊටත් කලින් නේ පයිතගරස් තියරි පයිතගරස් තියරි එක කියන්නේ කොහොමද මෙතන හරි ඍජු කෝණී කෝණයක් ගන්න කියන එකනේ සිම්පල් තියරි එතකොට පයිතගරස් මහත්තයා ඒක හදනකම් මිනිස්සු බිල්ඩින් හැදුවේ නැද්ද ආ පයිතගරස් මහත්තයා හැදුවමද මේ බිල්ඩින් ඩෙවලොප්මන්ට් එකේ ලොකු විප්ලවයක් රෙවොලූෂන් එකක් උනේ නෑ ඊට කලින් බිල්ඩින් හදලා නැද්ද පයිතගරස් මහත්මයා මං හිතන විදිහේ ඉඳලා තියෙන්නේ බුදුහාමුදුරජාණන් වහන්සේට සමකාලීනව මන් දන්න විදිහ මන් දන්නේ හරියට බලන්න එක චෙක්. ඒතර පිරමීඩ්ස් ඇති ඊට කලින් නේ. ඒතර ඒ වගේ ඍජු කෝණ ත්‍රිකෝණ ගත්තේ නැද්ද? ඍජු කෝණ 90ට ගත්තේ නැහැ අංශක 90ට ගත්තේ නැද්ද? ඒතර පයිතගරස් ප්‍රමේය කියන්නේ ඒක දිහා බලන් ඉඳලා එයා ලියපු වගන්තියක් නෙමේද? ග්‍රැවිටි එක කියන්නේ වැටෙන එක දිහා බලන් ඉඳලා ලියාගත්ත සෙන්ටෙන්ස් එකක් නෙමේද? දිසසටහන් න්‍යාය කියන්නේ යමක් වෙන දිහා බලාගෙන ඉඳලා ගොඩලගපු තියරි එකක් නෙමෙයිද? එහෙනම් ලෝකෙ ඉස්සෙල්ලම හැදුනේ මොකක්ද? ප්‍රැක්ටිස් එකද තියරි එකද? ප්‍රැක්ටිස් එක. That is very important to understand. Chartered accountancy is the practice. Accountancy graduate in Jayawardenapura. Accountancy graduate in Colombo. Accountancy graduate in Kalaniyo or any other university is the theory. But chartered accountancy is the practice. That's why they have highest demand when compared to the graduates. The world best thing is practice. You need theories to develop and going forward. But we need to talk about current situation, therefore we need the practice. Clear? අපි මොකද්ද කරන්නේ? තියරියක් ඔලුවට ගන්න. That's the issue. දැන් මම රියෝඩ ලෙවල් එක කරන්න යන්නේ. කියන්න යන්නේ. තියරි නෑ. තියරි නෑ. ඉතින් maximum demand per week into maximum lead time නේ නේද? එච්චර ලේසිද නේ? දැන් ඕක මම තේරුම් ගත්තට මම කියන්නේ. අපේ ගෙදර තාත්තට යමක් කරන්න ගෙනල්ලා දෙන්න කියලා කිව්වම අම්මා තාත්තා අනිවාර්යෙන් දවස් හතක් ගන්නවා අමතක වෙන නිසා. හරි මම ඇත්ත මේ කියන්නේ මම තේරුම් ගත්ත විදිහ කියන්නේ ඒ ලෙවල් කරන කාලේ. ඉතින් gedara hal naha කියලා මේ උයන්න විනාඩි 5 10ක් තියලා hal naha කියලා තාත්තට කිව්වොත් අපේ තාත දවස් දෙකක් ගන්න නම් බඩුවක් ගෙනල් දෙන්න ගෙදරට. වේල් කීයක් බඩගෙන ඉන්නවද අපිට? ඈ? හයක් බඩගෙන ඉන්න එන. ඉතින් අපේ අම්මා චාර්ට් ඇකවුන්ටන්ට් කෙනෙක් නෙමෙයි. හැබැයි වේල් හයකට කලින් තාත්තට කියන්න ඕනේ නැද්ද? හාල් ඉවරයි. කියන්න ඕනේ නේද? උදේ පාන්දර නැගිට ගමන් සීනි නෑ කිව්වොත් මොකද වෙන්නේ? තාත්ත දවස් දෙකකට පස්සේ නම් සීනි ගේන්නේ. දස් දැත් තේබුන්න වෙන්නේ නැහැ නේද? ඊන්ද අපි ඕඩර් කරන්න ඕන පරක් වෙන කාලෙට යන්න පුළුවන් උපරිම ප්‍රමාණය තියාගෙනද නැද්ද? තියාගෙන පරක් වෙන කාලෙට කියනවා ලීඩ් ටයිම් කියලා. යන්න පුළුවන් උපරිම ප්‍රමාණයට කියනවා යූසේජ් එක කියලා. Therefore your delivery is equal to maximum usage within the lead time and the maximum lead time. That's all. Clear? Total theory or formula, so practice. Clear again. Lead time is equal to the maximum usage within the lead time into maximum lead time. That now maximum usage per day into maximum lead time in days. Or maximum lead time, sorry, maximum usage per week into maximum lead time in weeks. That's depend, right? Right. Now you know what is reorder level. Clear? Once you ordered at the reorder level, on time, did you receive, right? Any stocks? It will take some time. Clear? Once you ordered, at that time you don't have stocks there. You have to wait until at least 1 second. After the order, at least you have to wait 1 second. Within this 1 second, company will consume in the stocks. Right? Therefore, from the date you order and the day you receive, there is a difference. But you believe as much as possible, as immediately as possible, you will receive goods. Clear? Therefore, this lead time can be considered minimum lead time, maximum lead time, then you will have average definitely. Ne? When you have minimum and maximum, you will have average. Ne? You will believe within minimum lead time, you will have stocks once you order. Is it clear? Right. Basically, you have a maximum stock level. The maximum quantity can be stored in the stores. Right? If you ordered amount as you wish, sometimes it may be exceed your capacity in the stores. Then what happen? You don't have spaces to stores. Then unnecessary cost for you. If you ordered less amount than your full capacity, then underutilization of the stores facility. Again, you have a cost there because you have a fixed cost there. Therefore, you must order to fill the stores. Is it clear? එක කෑල්ලක්වත් එළියේ තියෙන්නත් බෑ. ඇතුළේ ඉඩ තියෙන්නත් බෑ. From your order, your stores must be filled. Clear? Right. Simple example. Think this glass is the stores, right? This glass is the stores. Now, when it is in this level, you will load. Got it? When you order this at this level, to fill the glass, you need to order this cap. Got it? Is it clear what I'm explaining? You will order in at this level, right? To fill the stores, you have to order this cap. But while it receiving, you will consuming gradually. Clear? From this point, you will consuming gradually. At this point, you will order. But when you receiving it, you may hear. Got it? Therefore, reorder quantity should be this gap. Got it? This is very important. I'm talking about the calculation of EOQ in another way. Nobody talk about this. Got it? You will order at this level. Clear? But while order will receive, you will consume gradually. It will decrease. Say this point. Therefore, your order must fulfill from this point to this point. Therefore, this is the reorder quantity. Reorder quantity would be equal to what? Difference between maximum stock and reorder level plus the consumption in between the minimum lead time. Nobody talk about this. Clear? If you kilo a half kilo, you can half kilo. තාත්තා ගේද්දි හාල් කිලෝ 7ක් ඔක්කොම හාල් කිලෝ 20යි නම් ගෙදර තියාගන්න පුළුවන්. පහක් තියෙද්දි නම් තාත්තට ගේන්න කියන්නේ. 15ක් ගේන්න කියලා හරියන්නේ නැහැ. ඒතර 20 ෆිල් වෙන්නේ නැහැ. මොකද තාත්ත එනකන් තව කිලෝ දෙකක් කනවා නම් තාත්තා 17ක් ගේන්න ඕන. Therefore reorder quantity should be 17 kilograms. Difference between reorder level and maximum 15 plus consumption within minimum lead time. Got it? That should be the ROEOQ. Clear? Me hitanna man purudu karanne mara ganan hadawan denna meke elollu ganan deyak. Now based on that you can calculate what? Maximum stock level. If you add EOQ plus reorder level, what happen? Now you will order at this point, right? You cannot order this gap ne? Because while you receive the order, it will be reduced. Therefore, you have to order more than the gap. Clear? Therefore, if you add reorder level and EOQ, it go beyond the stores facility. Am I correct? Is it clear? Reorder level plus EOQ will have more than the maximum. Therefore, you have to eliminate additional amount. What is? Minimum consumption over minimum lead time. Write down the formula. Maximum stock level is equal to what? EOQ plus ROL within bracket, then minus, again within bracket, minimum consumption per day into minimum consumption in, sorry, minimum lead time in days. Clear? පැහැදිලිවද? දැන් යලි යන මට්ටමට EOQ එකතු කරාම අර උපරිමයට එහා යනවනේ. ඒතකොට උපරිම මට්ටම ගන්න අර වැඩිපුර ටික අයින් කරන්න ඕනේ. වැඩිපුර ටික අයින් කරනවා කියන්නේ අපි ඇසියුම් කරනවා කෙටි කාලය තුළ ලැබෙයි කියලා. නැත්නම් කෙටි කාලය තුළ කන්සම්ප්ෂන් එක අයින් කරාම තමයි මේ මැක්සිමම් එකේ නතර වෙන්නේ. නේ? හරි. ඔක තමයි මැක්සිමම් ස්ටොක් ලෙවල්. අපි හෙට කතා කරමු ඉතුරු ස්ටොක් සර්විස් ටිකයි. Questions. Right?